everyone, GXVL here with a brand new miraculous topic in regards about talking about the movie. Yes, that is right. This is a review, so please consider it done. And just to get right to the chase, I love the movie. Freaking 6 out of 7 Dragon Ball. That's how much I love this movie, and this is what fans like me needed, okay? Now, just to make this a little bit clear though, if you're expecting a movie not to have any musical numbers, then maybe the movie is not for you whatsoever. But I did not mind the musical numbers at all, because I thought they were much more well done here than how the TV show did, especially in regards to the Miraculous Christmas special when it comes to one of the voice actors. I think his name was Papernick, at least that's his last name, who voices the likes of not just Adrian Agres, Scott Newmar, but also the likes of Meliodas, which is the Dragon Sin of Wrath from The Seven Deadly Sins, and voices as Eren from Attack on Titan. When he was singing, he couldn't budge. He's not that much of a singer. He's a good actor, like a good voice actor, but not much of a good singer. All right, but the reason I had to mention that is because they got some other singing voice actors. Yeah, I have to emphasize on singing voice actors, because while you still get the likes of that guy voicing as Adrian and Christina V, who, just to also refresh everyone's memory, Christina V voices as the likes of Shantae, and especially the main character herself when it comes to Miraculous, and especially Hawk the Pig from The Seven Deadly Sins. All right, so as far as I know, she can sing. All right, Christina V can sing, but they got some other singing voice actors for these music numbers to do the singing for them, for both Christina V and even Papernick. I thought it was kind of just a little jarring, but you know what? I thought the singing was fine. The music numbers, I thought they were well executed, that they fit with the tone, how this movie is structured. So I really love that. I really dig that. The other thing I do want to address is that, like, yes, the animation does look stellar. It looks Pixar levels of stellar. I cannot deny that. But my only nitpick is not much of a criticism. It is a nitpick. When it comes to like Marinette's hair color, so they're either trying to go with like black hair with blue highlights when it comes to TV show, but we know for a fact that like when it comes to animation inconsistencies in different animated studios, is that like all her hair is just purely blue, right? And especially when it comes to like the original pilot anime promos, and especially trying to translate to like 3D animation, like, yeah, she's having a little bit more black hair, at least in 3D, or a little bit more of a dark bluish hair from her anime promo appearance. So they just need to make up their damn mind of what they want to go with, because I've just seen blatantly blue hair Marinette here. Again, just a nitpick, all right? Just a nitpick. Everything else just looks perfectly fine. The face expressions look really good. I really like the hair textures that they kind of go with. So yeah, that's really fine. Okay, so this I would consider to be kind of like a partial issue with the movie, because like while you get to see Tiki at least trying to have some interactions with Marinette and Ladybug, when it comes to Adrian communicating with Plague, not so much though. I'm not trying to claim myself to be like a really fan of Plague, but I can admit that like he does have a little bit of character from the show, the TV show, right? But they just made him more like a fart joke when interacting with Adrian. And I'm like, really, man? Like, come on. So that's just a little critique right there. I don't know why they even made that change, but oh well. What can you do? Because hey, it's for kids, right? What can make kids laugh? Oh, maybe a fart joke, right? When he's eating like moldy cheese, but whatever. The other thing I do want to mention when it comes to like criticism and gripes is that from the original show, they couldn't make up the damn minds what they want to do with Adrian's dad, the main villain, that is Gabriel Agres, Hawk Moth. They had a lot of issues trying to make the character work in the show. Now, in the movie, they improve upon the character. And I'm gonna talk about him in a video from a while back. So I'm happy to see that Hawk Moth, Gabriel Agres, is looks and feels a little bit more competent and a little bit more sympathetic and comes across as a tragic villain. Maybe sympathetic may not be the right word, but anyways, you understand what he is trying to do until he just falls apart at the very end and admits his faults, especially towards his own son. So I thought this was the biggest, greatest takeaway from the movie. And also, his music number, when it comes to like villains, it was actually spot on when trying to like get some villains out of a prison cell, all right? The other thing I do want to mention is that when it comes to pacing, okay, this is just another partial issue. This is a partial issue I have, is where I'm like, okay, I feel like the pacing is just a tad bit fast. Not like too fast by any means. Like, at least the pacing I can tolerate, but I just wish it was a little slow. Just a little slow, all right? So, yeah, I just think they can just make it a little bit balanced the next time, because they are thinking about like working on a sequel if you've seen the movie and saw the ending of it. But hey, that is my other issue with this movie, aside from Plague, and maybe again that was just a nitpick though. So but here, like, pacing, like, it was just a tad bit fast, but at least I can tolerate it. The story structure, the way it flows, I thought it was fine, and especially very slice of life and wholesome for the most part when going for that romantic route with between Marinette and Adrian. And the chemistry feels a little bit more real for me. And that it feels a lot more competent, no padding when it comes to this TV show. They kept on going with this whole circle jerking with the whole love square thing of their different personalities or whatever, their personas. This right here, they just make it work, and I like that. That's another thing that they pulled through from this movie. And you do get to see the characters, the two main characters, end up with each other, right? And I do want to say one thing. I think my other, maybe just small gripe or whatever, I'm not too sure if I would consider it as a nitpick or maybe as a critique, but I just wish I would have seen, like, a little bit more of Adrian's perspective, because in the first half of the movie it does strongly feel as Marinette's perspective for the most part. But luckily, at least they don't treat Adrian slash Cat Noir as a joke like in most episodes from the TV show, so that's a big plus at least. I just wish I would see a little bit more Cat Noir perspective here and there, but at least they treat him a little bit more respectfully, and I just wish they would have given him an awesome transformation sequence like they did with Ladybug when she was doing her singing moment. So instead they went with like I wouldn't call it like maybe Super Saiyan, but it felt like it to me, like Plague calls out, he charges up like a Super Saiyan just without the aura. So I was like, okay, like a quick transformation sequence, okay then. Just a little bit of like minor gripes from my end, all right? There are some other side characters that I do recognize, and I'm kind of glad they don't get that much of a chance or a spotlight, because you do want to focus at least on the main characters. Oh, but I think there's just one more thing I'm neglecting, and that is Master Fu. On how they handled him, sadly, not too much, but you know what? I can forgive it. And especially that he feels a little bit more competent in a certain extent than with the TV show. I can see that there's a lot of people not too keen on Master Fu being handled in the TV show, which I can see why. This one, he feels a little bit more competent, and instead of like of how they got their powers just because Master Fu is just doing the most simplistic task just to see who could be a true hero, like, no, you just see Master Fu, like, he just wants the Miraculous to behave, and so he can see who he can choose wisely. But no, like, the Miraculous is like Tiki and Plague, they went all like all skyrocketing crazy. He has to go captures them until like Marinette is like, oh, be careful, old man, because he was about to get hit, and that was by accident actually. So I'm like, okay, then that's better. That's actually better. All right, so yeah, that's all I had to say. I don't think I'm forgetting anything else that I have to mention. But again, I would strongly recommend checking out this movie, okay? This is Vajigs VL saying off right now. Later. If you love and enjoy the content of my channel, please like and subscribe. If you are already a subscriber of mine, please check up on my community tabs for updates, especially for upcoming live streams, so we can have interactive discussions. Furthermore, check out my Newgrounds and or Pixiv profile pages to see my artwork archives. Negative and or positive feedbacks are welcome. But be warned that I do favorite artwork that is not suitable for all ages and come across as uncomfortable. Check out my blogs only on Newgrounds to be updated on my whereabouts and upcoming or in-progress works. Lastly, please visit my Letterboxd page to read and see my written movie reviews rather than my videos, and see if we can have a discussion there if you disagree with my takes. Welcome to the GXV Outburst, and stay tuned.